And just a couple.
And of course, you are watching our live coverage of the Crew-8 launch. This was NASA and SpaceX's third attempt after two weather delays. Let's get back out to WestU Scott Heidler, who has been covering the mission from the very start. Scott, I know you were excited. You heard the sonic boom and all of the call outs, all of them pointing in a very good direction.
Absolutely. Yeah, we heard the sonic booms just a little bit ago, probably about 2.5 minutes ago. You know, we're over 11 minutes now into the flight, and it is in orbit. Crew-8 is now in orbit, so they got to where they need to be. What's going to happen now? Again, well, actually, let's just backtrack. Everything went through very, very smoothly. You know, we had two scrubs, weather, third time's a charm tonight. You know, everything was going through very smoothly, 90% weather go, you know, about an hour before launch. And then there was something that came up that could be a technical issue. That was solved. They agreed that there was going to be no threat with that, so they proceeded, and what a beautiful launch. And now it's in orbit. What's going to happen? It's going to take until 3 a.m. on Tuesday for the Endeavour capsule to catch up to the International Space Station. That's when it will dock. It'll stay docked for probably about 2 or 3 hours before the hatch actually opens. That's when Crew-8, the four members of Crew-8, will enter the International Space Station. There'll be a handover for about 5 days with Crew-7 and the other members up there on the International Space Station. Then Crew-7 will make their way back down to Earth. So this is the beginning of a 6-month journey for these astronauts, three astronauts, one cosmonaut. Again, over 200 science experiments that they're bringing up, that they're going to be working on. There's already a lot going on the International Space Station. So it's going to be a very busy time, and kind of leading up to the launch tonight, there was discussion about what's going to be happening on the schedule in that 6 months. Yes, those science experiments, but other craft coming up, cargo missions, other crewed missions, one coming up that's going to launch from Russia, bringing up a NASA astronaut as well. So it's going to be a very busy time at the International Space Station. What's become interesting over the last several months, almost even a year here at the Kennedy Space Center and on the Cape, is that it's becoming so busy that they're scheduling conflicts. You wouldn't think that just a couple of years ago, but right now there's so much activity here going up to low Earth orbit that there are scheduling conflicts. So that's something that really is part of the process now when they talk through when they're going to be crewed missions. There's so many other missions going on at the same time, and the launch pads are very busy. So that's something that's becoming, I guess it's a good problem to have. It's busy times here because there's so many launches. Again, this year, Kennedy Space Center, the Cape in general, with the Space Force Base 2, they're looking to go over 100 launches in 1 year. We're talking records that have never even been thought of in the last 5-6 years. So right now, it's a very busy time, and we just saw that today with the successful launch of Crew-8. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, WestU News.